Hi, everybody. Kathi Hanson here. What prompted me to make this little basic drawing techniques video is so many times when people are looking at any of the work I've created, they say, wow, that's beautiful, but I could never do that. When actually you really could if you just knew a few basic pencil techniques, and as with any other medium, practice makes perfect. So here's a short little tutorial on basic pencil techniques. First of all, a pencil can have a sharp tip or a rounded tip. I'm going to zoom in for this. A sharp tip is meant to be used to fill in small, tight areas or create linear marks. Now, this is an HB. That is the hardest of the soft pencils, and it's going to give you about that degree. If you want a lighter degree, then you would go with a 2H, which is the softest of the hard. Notice the hard lay down less pigment in thinner lines, and soft pencils deposit more pigment and wider lines. When you are going to draw, fill in an area, you want to use a rounded tip. And just like when you work in colored pencil, you're going to sort of do it in circles that slightly overlap each other. You don't put a lot of pressure down into the paper. You have a light touch, and if you want it darker, you're just going to layer more, okay? Now, in every object you create, you need a minimum of three values to create form and dimension. Your three basic pencils that I use in most of my designs are my light values in HB, my mid value is a 2B, and my darks are a 6B. Sometimes I even go darker, so I would adjust it and use different degrees, but these are my three main ones for depositing values, and my 2H or my HB is what I use for linear. I would use a 2H if I wanted a light line in a light area, then I would use the HB if I wanted a line in a mid value area. Okay, you're always adjusting to the value, the previous value that's on the paper. So let's say we were going to fill in an area with three values. Notice when I, especially when I put the first value on, I am not in a handwriting position. It tends to be darker, more controlled. Deposits much more pigment very quickly and sometimes can embed it into the pigment, which we don't want. We want it sitting more up on the top of the surface so we can manipulate it and blend it out. So I usually put my thumb and index finger right around where it says USA or general pencil. And light touch, I just start filling in the area. Probably going a little darker than I normally do, so this will pick it up. If I want the line stationary, I'm done. If I want it to soften up, then I back up on my pencil even more because it's a lighter touch, looser. And as I go further and further away, the pencil actually is hitting the paper less and less and less and less and less, and I can soften it out to nothing. Here's my 2B. Now, I always want some of the previous value showing, so I would stop this easily about there. No, I would want it to end there, so I'll stop it about here because I need to be able to soften that edge out. So now I'm putting a 2B value down. Hit that mark. So now I softer and softer and softer and softer. See how I have two values showing? My 6B is my darkest, so that I'm going to stop right here. I basically just want a little bit of this on the end to really set that line in. Now, see how I have all these values. Now, if you want it to look very soft, then I blend with a tortillon, tortillion, however you want to say it. Here's my first value. And I'm working a little faster now because I am going to be softening it out with my blending tool. I always tell everybody, The only time you want to hold this in a handwriting position is if you want to set a line in, make it a little darker and a little more painterly looking. Okay? Now notice, because that tortillion now has pigment on it, I even could pull it out much further if I really wanted to and have more than one value in that line. So you want to actually have it horizontal, the paper. I always tell everyone, drop it, pick it up with your index finger and thumb, and holding it horizontal with a light touch, start blending. You notice how the lines just start blending and it looks so much smoother, less textured than if you are just softly blending it out just with the tip of the pencil pigment. When I get to this area, I'm going to put the dirty part of the tortillion up in the pigment area and let the clean part hit the paper. And now as I pull it away from me, I just soften that out to nothing. Can you see that? Now I'm going to come in with my 2B pencil, the same thing. I want some of this still showing. Hands far back. And I'm going to lay my second color in. Now sometimes I don't need the tortillon to do it. This is a good example. I'm lightening up that touch. And you see how that edge softened out to nothing? You can do it either way. Now I'm going to do my 6B, and I'm even going to do that in a smaller area. See how I've created all these wonderful values, and all these values are what give form to an object. Now I'm going to show you a few cheat ways to do it. If you are having a hard time, because an HB pencil, even though it's on the soft side, it's hard. And sometimes people have a real hard time getting a real light value in. So another way you can do it is, I like to take powder graphite, and I can either load a cotton ball with it and put some of the light value in. Now this is a darker light value. I'm going to wipe this off. If I had less in there, see how much of a softer value that is. So it's just how much you load on it. Sometimes you can take a dirty tortillion. This one's super dirty, so I don't need to load it with more graphite and then wipe it off, but I could have. So sometimes with a very light touch, this is a way to get your first value in. And then you would come back with your second value and continue that same process. So, you know, I don't like to have everybody automatically do this because I want you to learn how to put all your values in with your pencils whenever possible. But sometimes for a beginner, or if it's in a real tight little area or something, this is another way to do it. See how I have two values in there? Now I'll come back with that 6B again, because this will give you a blended finish visual. The other one was a drawn visual. More texture, much softer. This is great for like petals or brass, something smooth. This is a great way to get lots of textures in, say, your tree trunk or something like that. You need several values. That's what gives something dimension. Now I want to talk a few seconds about erasing. A kneaded eraser is, now mine's dirty. So when it's dirty, guys, you don't throw it away. You just fold it into itself until you get a nice clean area. You can put it in whatever shape you want, okay? A light touch is going to extract just a little pigment in an area. Tap, tap, tap. If you press really hard, it's going to extract more, which is going to give you a brighter white. If you want the area to be totally white, then my first eraser of choice is a Factus Extra Soft ES20 eraser. This is extra soft white vinyl. It is so soft, the surface integrity of your paper can never be compromised. And what I mean by that is when you go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, you can start lifting off the top surface coating of your paper, and it will tend to get a little nubby or something. And when you lay pigment down, it's going to grab. That will never happen with this. So I can totally extract with that. If it's a very dark area, sometimes this is too soft. So then I do have to go to a plastic eraser. Now, there's hard plastic and soft plastic. You want soft plastic. This is pretty darn pliable for plastic. Again, we're thinking of protecting the surface integrity. But this effortlessly erases. You know you have a good eraser. I'll do it with the ES22. When they effortlessly extract in one swipe, where you don't have to go back and forth, back and forth. A lot of people automatically take their fingers, try to do this, it can smear it. I always use a Dynasty number 10 or 8, 8500 camel hair mop brush. Camel hair is so soft, again, it effortlessly will remove pigment and not embed it. It's not for painting. Another brush I use sometimes is a small flat blender. It's an IPC 2 by Dynasty. For this one, now this is dirty, it's got a little bit on it. This is another time I sometimes will put my soft value in an area. If I've loaded it more with pigment, the very first swipe is going to be darker, and then as I move it out and there's less pigment, I can make it lighter and lighter and lighter and lighter and lighter. I do things like this when I am, I want an object obvious, but not as obvious as something sitting in front of it in the foreground that I've applied pencil pigment in an area. There's so many tips and tricks. I incorporate each and every one of these techniques and more in every one of my pattern packets. Every packet design introduces a different technique than in a previous one, because we're all constantly learning. And if I put every technique in a design, it would just overwhelm you. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this little bit of a tutorial. I hope you pull out some pencils and paper and practice. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the message area on my website, and I will get back to you. Well, take care, laugh a lot, and create often. Kathy Hanson signing off here. Bye.